Okay, so line integral, we have gone through the vector calculus. Like we started the vector calculus, so in that topic we have started with the vector field, right? So vector field, divergence and curl, so we know about those stuff. Now we are entering into the calculus part of it today. Okay, the first topic is line integral. So like in vector calculus, the calculus part is starting today. Got the idea? We studied about the vector field, what is vector field, how it look like. Now we are going to apply calculus to it. Okay, so I'm going to write one expression here, like integration of a to b f of x dx. Fine, what this represent?
Area.
The area under a particular curve from A to B.
So area under the curve. Okay, area under the curve f of x. Right. And the integration is along x direction. So x is equal to A to x is equal to B. Now if I tell you that f of x is the mass density function, then what this integral represent?
Mass.
Yes.
So mass of the object,
straight wire, straight thin wire. Can you recall this thing that we studied long before? Maybe the mass of a straight thin wire from A to B, right? If f of x is the mass density function. Right, so whatever area we get, like area under the curve, whatever area we get, that area is numerically equal to the mass, right? So area is numerically equal to mass. Now like if I try to interpret this on a graph, this is what I mean to say. We have a thin straight wire and we are integrating within A to B. Okay, we are integrating along x direction. Okay, now if suppose, can we find out the mass of a wire which is not straight? Like, can we still find out the mass of this type of wire?
The mass?
Yes. Mass of this wire.
Yeah, mass.
See, we can definitely find out. Yeah, we'll definitely find out. Yeah. That's why I raised the question. Otherwise, there's no use of line integral. So basically, the topic is here. We can find out the mass of this curve wire. Okay, mass of this curve wire. So far we have seen that we can find out mass of a straight wire by using this integral, right? Now we can even find out mass of curve wire that I have drawn on the screen, right? So here, if how would I write, like, this is the function, right? From where I should start with and to end with this, right? But this is not, this is basically, how do I represent a curve which is not a function? You got the line? Do I represent a curve which is not a function? Any idea? How do I represent? See, this is a curve which is not a function, right? Because this does not pass the vertical line test, that you know. This is the basic, right? How do I represent this? Is there any way to represent this type of curve? Definitely, yes. You know the term also.
Parametric.
Parametric. Perfect. Yeah. We can represent this curve by a parameter, right? So that's called the parametric representation of a curve, right? So if I need two variable, right? F of x comma y to get to each point on this curve, right? I need two variable, that is f of x comma y now. So if I integrate this with respect to the small segment along this curve, that is called ds, right? That's very little tiny segment along this curve, that is called ds. So if we are integrating, please understand, see, you always understand the concept properly, okay? The process of solving problem is very easy. I can give you the formula, I can explain you the steps, but understand the concept, okay? So I have to represent this curve by two variable, right? That is f of x comma y. If I integrate this function with respect to s, okay, where ds is very small little segment along this curve, if I integrate this, what would I get? If this f of x comma y is mass density function, then we can find out the mass of this non-straight wire, right? We can find out this wire, the mass of this wire, isn't it? So this happens only if f of x comma y is mass density function, right? Now what's the problem here? Are you getting the problem? How would I solve this? See, this integral will be over the curve, okay? So my reason is just a curve, right? It is just a curve. So over the curve, we have to integrate f of x comma y with respect to s. So can we integrate this? Like, see, we have two variable x and y here, and we have to integrate with respect to s, right? Where ds is the small segment along the curve. So to find out the integration here, we have to convert x and y in terms of s. Make sense? What is the variable here? What is the variable? Variable is s. So to understand this expression or to find the integration of this, we have to convert x and y, or this f of x comma y, in terms of s, right? So that's not so easy. Yeah. So we have to set up a parametric equation, right? Means f of x comma y is also represented in terms of one parameter t. That's typically we take a parameter called t, right? And at the same time, this ds will also be converted in terms of t, right? So let's understand how it works. Like, so to integrate this, okay, we have to define, okay, we have to do two things. We have to define C, the curve, in parametric equation. And the second is, this ds is arc length, right? This ds is arc length. So we can convert this ds in the parametric form. Okay, let's see how it happens. So basically, see, if what is this f of x comma y, is this represent a curve? F of x comma y, the function represent a curve?
Or the mass density.
Yes. Mass density. The function never represent the function never represent region, right? The function which we write after the integration, that never represent region, right? The region is C here, that is along the curve, right? So f of xy is not, that does not represent curve. That's the, like, that's basically z value to that, right? F of x comma y is a surface. Are you getting that? Please relate a lot of things together. F of x comma y is a surface. So that gives you the z value, yeah, right? That gives you the z value to it. So that is basically f of x comma y is a mass density function, that this will definitely give you the mass, right? Right? But f of x comma y is the surface. So if I suppose this is your curve, right? Let's say this is your curve and we have surface over it, and that this curve like intersect the surface. This is surface, right? F of x comma y. So this curve have a, you know, projection, you can say, on this surface. So this is the part of the projection of this curve on this surface, right? And we are integrating over this curve, okay? We are integrating over this curve, along this curve. So the small segment of this curve is ds. Very little tiny segment of this curve is what? Ds, right? So if I integrate along this curve, what we get here? See, I have removed one dimension of this. If you think of the double integration, if you remove one dimension from it, what you get? What basically double integration gives you? If you have a region on XY plane, what double integration gives you?
Volume.
Very good. So if I remove one dimension from it, if I remove one dimension from it, that will give you the area, right? So you can think of the, like this curve has only one dimension, right? I have removed one dimension from this. So that double integration no longer exists here. We have a single integration here over, that is applied to f of x comma y with respect to s, right? So this gives the area of this curtain. Are you getting that? This gives the area of the curtain. Can you visualize the curtain here?
Yeah.
Right? Over the curve, under the surface. That gives the area of the curtain. Like this ds is, you can consider that ds is width and f of x comma y is the length of each rectangle, right? So f of x comma y, f of x comma y into ds will give you the area. Area of what? Area of curtain, you can say. Okay, this f of xy is height and ds is length, you can say, right? So this gives the area. If suppose f of x comma y is mass density function, then what would that integration will give you? Mass.
The full.
That will give you the mass.
Yeah, the full integral. Double.
No, what I'm saying, if this f of x comma y is mass density function, then this integration will give you the mass, right? That will give you the mass.
Yeah.
Right. So now see, this is the area of one rectangle here. This is the area of one rectangle. Now we are talking about in terms of area here. This is the area of one rectangle. How would I get the area of the complete curtain here? We have to apply the integration, isn't it?
Yeah.
We have to apply the integration f of x comma y ds. This will give you the area of the curtain over this region, over this curve. Okay. So therefore, called line integral. It should have called curve integral also, but the little tiny segment of that curve is always be line. It will always give you a sense of line because we integrate as for the infinite segments, right? So that small little teeny segment is a line. That's why it is called as line integral. Got the idea here?
Yeah.
Okay, so we add up the area and that gives the area under f of x comma y, but only over curve C. Okay, now I was talking about double integration, like this double integration over region R f of x comma y dA. This gives volume, right? This gives volume, right? If I remove one integration from this, if I remove one dimension from it, and if I integrate with respect to S along the curve, it will give you the area. And if this f of x comma y is mass density function, this will give you the mass of that non-straight wire or mass of the wire. Okay. Now, but the problem is still there, that how would I integrate this with respect to S? Okay. So as I told you, we can like convert this function in terms of parametric equation, and similarly, like at the same time, this ds also converted to that parametric equation or in terms of parameter. Okay, so we'll get, since we have only single integral, isn't it? So we can integrate with respect to only one variable, right? So we have to convert everything in terms of some other parameter so that we can integrate it. Are you getting the idea here? Right?
Yeah.
So f of x comma y can always be converted into parameter. Please verify. Any curve, any like equation, any function can always be converted into parameter. And that parameter is like, that will give you one variable, you know, the sense of one variable. So we can always integrate one variable with single integral. Isn't it? Make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, so what's our job reduced to now is, we are given two variable here over this curve, right? We have to convert it into one variable form, right? This is what our requirement now. So as you told, like during the class only, that we can convert the curve which is not a function, okay, we can write the curve which is not a function in terms of parameter. So f of x comma y can always be written as f of x of t y of t, isn't it? Okay. Now I'm taking one expression, like this is from the maybe chapter 10 from the book you have provided me, that is about the parametric equation. Okay, so the arc length is basically square root of x dash t square plus y dash t square with respect to dt. Does this make sense to you? The arc length is, see, you know, like maybe in AP you might have this expression, ds is equal to root 1 plus dy by dx the whole square dx, right? And if we apply integration to find out the arc length. Are you getting the idea here? Like this was there in AP,
yeah.
AP calculus. To find out the arc length, this was the formula. We can even discuss this in detail some other day, maybe when we do the parametric equation. but not right now, because it will like completely change the way I should go with this line integral. Okay, but you definitely be like sure about this equation, because this we have already done in calculus AP calculus, right? The arc length can be found out by integration of root 1 plus, you know, change of y with respect to s square dx. Okay, don't worry, I give you the idea about little bit idea, because I know that if you don't verify this, the whole lecture going to be waste maybe. So what is this? If suppose x is equal to 1 here, okay, see, this is the curve, this is the little segment of the curve is ds, right? And if you take the differential, that is going to be very small. It will give you the sense of simple line. Are you getting that? So we can always find out distance by using like the length of ds by using distance formula. So if there is a change in x is by 1 unit, what is the corresponding change in y? That is dy by dx, right? Are you getting that? So if you find ds by using distance formula, so it's the distance is always like square root of, you know, 1 square plus dy by dx the whole square, right? And we integrate this along x direction. Are you getting the idea here? So therefore, if you integrate this, this will always give you the arc length. Please verify if you understood this.
Yo, go.
Then I'll move ahead. Now this equation has been changed to in terms of the parameter. Okay. With respect to t. So if you do a little bit work over there, you can definitely have this equation. Let me do that little bit. I'll just show you the pseudo proof of it, not the complete proof. So see, this is like one, if you take dy by dx common, okay, or see, this is dx the whole square plus dy the whole square, right? What we get outside,
outside where,
like here,
outside as in
what should I see? I have considered this dy and dx as separate terms of the fraction. So dx square plus dy square upon dx square, dx square will come outside the square root, dx will cancel out. You can like, this is just a working like the pseudo proof, as I told you, this is not the exact proof. So dx will cancel out, right? Now if I want to convert this into the parametric form, so I will simply differentiate this with respect to t. Okay, so this can also always be written as in terms of t. Okay, since this is dx, so derivative of that x with respect to t, derivative y with respect to t, and the variable of the integration is t. T will come out from the square root. We'll discuss this some other day, but at least like I'm giving you the sense of this equation. Does that make sense to you?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, fine. Because the whole idea is dependent on this. Okay. So let's stick to the topic, that's line integral. Now, since ds is equal to, like we got this, this is ds. Now, how would I write the parametric equation of the given curve? I want to write this curve in terms of the parametric equation. So, like this is the vector form of the curve, right? I can write this as x of t I cap plus y of t j cap. This is the parametric form of the curve. Okay. Now, let's integrate this. So the integration of this will give you the gradient, right? Gradient of this vector form of the curve is also vector, right? Gradient is also vector. So that is x dash t I cap plus y dash t j cap. Okay. Now, how would I take the, like, if you take the modulus of this, what are we getting here? How would I find the magnitude of this vector, this gradient vector?
That gives you ds only, right? Ds.
Yes, yes. So square root of x dash t, the whole square, plus y dash t, the whole square. Okay. So this is exactly what we have written for ds. Okay, ds is equal to that part into dt. Dt is also there, right? That's not the complete ds. Okay, so how should I write ds for? So ds is equal to mod of r dash t dt.
Dt.
Right? So here we have converted, or we got the ds in terms of t, in terms of parameter. Okay, now what about this? Now we already converted the given function in terms of t, right? So we can now use this single integration over this curve. Okay, f of x y ds. Now this can be written as, see, what is f of x comma y? F of x of t comma y of t. And what is ds? Ds is mod of r dash t dt. Okay, now we can integrate this, right? We can integrate this with respect to t. We got only one variable for the single integration, right? And what is the limit of this integration? It goes from t is equal to a to t is equal to b. Like t goes linearly. Are you getting that? As t passes from a to b, it covers the whole curve. It covers the whole curve. Whereas if you look at this diagram where x changes from this point to this, it does not cover the complete curve here. Are you getting that? So that's why we need a third variable, the parameter, which can define the complete curve here, right? So as t goes from a to b, it will define the complete curve. And therefore, our single integration is converted from this double variable to single variable. And we can definitely solve this easily. Did you understand the whole concept here?
Yes.
See, I try another way to give you this expression. Maybe you will definitely verify that. How do we find out the, you know, the length, arc length? The arc length, if suppose t goes from a to t, t is equal to b, right? This will give us the arc length, right? This will give us the arc length. Are you getting that? If we integrate s, ds along the curve, see, s, this ds is basically the small segment along the curve, right? So if we integrate over that curve, it will give you the arc length, right? From t is equal to a to t is equal to b. But what is ds? Since this, the variable is t here, so we should write the expression which we found here, right? So ds is equal to mod r dash t dt. So we got the variable here. Now this will give you the arc length. How would I find out the area of the curtain? We have to multiply this by the length, right? The height. What is the height here? The function itself. What is the height? The function in terms of parameter, right? So f of x, x of t, y of t, mod r dash t dt, right? So this is one and same thing. So you can have any, like, the idea should be clear to you. Like, we are finding out the area of the curtain over the curve under the surface, some surface, and that curve must be projected on that surface. There should be connection between that curve and the surface. And if suppose that function f of x comma y represent a mass density function, then this area is numerically equal to
mass.
Right. Okay. Do you want me to recap this thing? Like, you understood the whole idea here, or should I recap it?
I got it.
Okay. Mano? Yeah, drink water.
Got it.
Okay, fine. So let me put up the example here. So we have to integrate this y ds over this curve, right? And the curve is represented in terms of parameter by this. We will do parameter equations some other day, okay, in detail. I should have taken that chapter first, but it's okay. I have tried to explain you in the very common way, so that you can relate it with the AP calculus which you have studied before. Okay, so we'll do it in detail. So r dash t is equal to 2t I cap plus t cube j, that represents your curve in terms of parameter, where t goes from 0 to 1. Okay. Now, what is our x and what is our y here?
The
2t and t cube.
Yes. See, x is the x component of this curve. Mm-hmm. Y is the y component of this curve.
Yeah.
Okay. So, x is equal to 2t, and y is equal to t cube. Okay, f of x comma y will give you the function. The function is already given, that we are going to plug there in terms of t. Okay, wherever we find x, we replace that by 2t. Wherever we find y, we replace that by t cube. Okay, so we have to integrate this.
So I have a question. Where did the vector come from? I didn't understand why are we using, like, how come the vectors come in this?
Yeah, that part you are asking me. This part. We have represented curve in terms of vector. See, I give you the diagram so that you can understand this part a little bit. See, this is the curve, right? This is the curve. Fine. We can always represent this curve in terms of vector, in terms of the position vector. Right, this is your r dash t. So it's from t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 1, you will get your rt. As this, see, as t start from 0 and end to 1, so as t goes from 0 to 1, you will always get a path of the curve, where the path of the curve is denoted in terms of vector. See, we always have the coordinate, right?
Okay.
Maybe 3 comma 1. So we can define this position vector. So rt is equal to 3 I cap plus 1 j cap, right? So this vector changes over this curve, isn't it? Because that's the position vector. That vector changes over this curve as t goes from 0 to 1. So I knew this, I knew that, like, you are going to face some difficulty while when I explain you the parameter equation. I knew that, but I'm trying to put little bit sense to it. Like, if I define can I define the curve in terms of parameter, like I have defined here? Can you see that? So curve is going like this as t goes from 0 to 1. Can I define the curve in terms of parameter? Because that parameter is in is like a position vector of each point. Are you getting that?
Yeah.
See, parameter equation of this, you know, that define each point over this curve is basically the position vector of that point. Please head yes, you've understood this. I'm trying to cover up the parametric concept also here little bit.
Okay. I understand.
Even you will find little bit difficulty in this also, because I have found derivative by differentiating x of t and y of t separately. So I'll explain that, the concept behind it. But you just take this as it is for a while. Okay. See, this is the curve. This is that. This is the curve in terms of parameter. So the derivative of that curve is also a vector form. That is also be a vector. It's a gradient. It's a tangent, right? That's also a vector. So that derivative is nothing but the derivative of this curve is also a vector whose components are the derivative of the curve. Derivative of x of t and y of t, like that. Okay. Got the idea?
Yeah.
Sure.
So the derivative of the vector is basically like its slope, right?
Yeah. Slope of the vector. Okay. Right. For time being, you can call this as like what you are saying. I'll prove that. I'll prove that. After proving, you will definitely get the same thing what we are applying here. Okay. So now let's come to the question. So this is the vector form of the curve, right? This is the parametric equation which represent the curve. Got the idea here? Which is 2t I cap plus t cube j cap. So what is x here? X is the x component of this curve, and y is the y component of this curve. So wherever we find x and y, because see, we trying to find out certain surface by using this x and y, right? Some imaginary surface is there where this curve is projected on that surface, and we get the area, right? If this function, the function y, see y is given there. If this function is mass density function, then whatever integration we are finding out here, that is the mass of that wire along this curve. Okay.
Yeah.
So x is equal to 2t, comma y is equal to t cube. So what things we have to find out? We have to find out this and this. So let's find out r dash t first of all. So before that, we have to define r t, right? R t already given, or r t we already given here. That is 2t I cap plus t q j cap. Now we'll find out the derivative of this. What is derivative? What will be the derivative of this?
2i cap plus
2 3 2 square j cap.
Can we find out the magnitude of this? We need that, right? So that's this square root of 2 square
plus
3 plus
plus 9 2.
Perfect. So 4 plus 9 t raised to 4. Okay. What else we need? We need this function, right? What is that? That's just y. And we have to write y in terms of the parameter, right? So what is y in terms of parameter?
Yeah.
T cube, right?
T cube.
Perfect. So that integration can be changed to t cube root 4 plus 9 t raised to 4. dt, right? Now where t goes from 0 to
1.
Now, can we integrate this? U substitution.
Yeah.
Okay, so like if you integrate this, 4 plus 94 should be taken as U 36 TQ, TT is equal to DU, and as T is equal to 0, U is equal to 4, T is equal to 1, U is equal to 13. So U goes from 4 to 13, and TQ, okay, 36 TQ, so 1 over 36 DU root U. Fine. So 1 over 36 U raised to 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2, and then we apply the limit here. 4, 13.
1 by 54.
1 by?
Oh, you have to change that. No, you have to change the limit.
Yeah. So, that's U raised to 3 by 2, right? So, 13 square cube root minus the square root of 4 is 2 and the cube is 8. So this weird expression is the answer to this.
So it's 13 cube by square root. It's 13 cube square root.
Okay, yeah, fine. So perfect. So 13 cube. No. Yeah, 13 cube square root, perfect. So 13, 1 over 36 into 2 by 3 into, we can take 13 out of it. 13 root 13 minus 8. Nothing will change, no? 54. Yeah. Just 1 over 54.
Yeah.
So this is the answer to this. Now let's go to the next question. That's this line integral over this curve with respect to S, and the curve is defined as a right half circle of x square plus y square is equal to 9. How would you solve this? Now, can we represent the given curve in terms of parameter here? And how would I represent that? This is the equation of the curve. So what is x and y in terms of parameter? Since this is the circle, right? Do you know the parametric equation of the circle? X is equal to R
letter alphabet cos theta.
Cos theta, yeah. Let's stick to our typical variable, that is t. So x is equal to R cos t, where t is obviously angular measurement. Okay. And y is equal to R sin t. What is R here?
Three.
So x is equal to 3 cos t, y is equal to 3 sin t, right? Now, what is ds? We have to find out ds, right? So ds will be replaced by mod of r bar dash t, right? So let's find out, first of all, let's write the parametric form of the given curve. So what is parametric form of the given curve here? R of t is equal to, whose x component is 3 cos t and y component is 3 sin t, right? प्लस 3 sin t j cap. Okay, this is the parametric equation of the curve. See this, we knew this, no? We knew this, how to represent curve in terms of parameter, right? Right there? We knew this. We know this yeah. for like circle, we know this for maybe ellipse or lot of curve. We know that how to convert the parametric, the given equation, rectangular equation in terms of rectangular coordinate system is converted to parametric form. This is how we do it. So r of t is equal to 3 cos t I cap plus 3 sin t j cap. The only thing is like, what would be the derivative of this? The change, that derivative is the tangent that has to be vector also, right? The vector, the tangent is a vector whose component is the derivative of this x component and the derivative of the y component of this given curve. So what would be the derivative of 3 cos t?
3 sin t.
Minus 3 sin t I cap. And the derivative of 3 sin t is 3 cos t j cap. Right? Now, how would I find out the mod of this? Magnitude of this? Square root of x square plus y square. What is x? X is 3 cos t. 9 cos square t plus 9 sin square t, and that is equal to 3. Fine. Now, what is the function? See, the function is x square plus y square. Okay, so what is x square plus y square? If you write, you know, in terms of r, you need to have double integration. But don't write that, because we have x r, the r value is 3, right? So x is equal to 3 cos t, y is equal to 3 sin t. See, if you draw the curve, it will give you the sense of region that we talked about in double integration. That's the curve, right? That's the half part of the circle, right half of the circle. X square plus y square is equal to 9, whose center is 0, 0, radius is 3, right? This gives you the sense of region here. But we are not double integrating it over the region. We are integrating over the curve, right?
Yeah.
The r is still changing from, yeah. like r is still 3. The theta changing from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, right? But our region is along the curve. It's not the half circle. Okay? So therefore, this is like, this is the line integral. We are integrating along the line, along the curve, right? Should have called curve integral. Don't worry. Because of the integral integration, the sense of the little tiny segment is line. That's why it is called line integral. Okay, fine. So the magnitude of r dash t is 3. Now, okay. What was my function? The function is x square plus y square. What is that? Can we write that in terms of parameter?
Yeah.
R square.
So should I write r square or 9?
But you can't write r square because it's in terms of t.
Yeah. That. See, this is just for your reference. Like, we can find out this in terms of parametric equation. R no longer exists here because r is 3.
So you write it as 9.
Yeah. Definitely. So the integration over this curve, okay, now this will change to in terms of parameter. So x is 9 cos square t plus 9 sin square t, and magnitude of r dash t is 3, and what else? Dt. Right?
Yeah.
And t goes from what? What is t? T is the angular measurement. T still goes from
minus pi by 2 to pi by 2.
Pi by 2. Perfect. Minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Very good. You got the idea?
You could have said, you could have done 0 to pi by 2 into 2.
0, yeah, that we can definitely do by using the property of definite integral after this. But t goes from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, right? To solve this, we can definitely use the property of definite integration. Okay, fine. So what is this? 9 3 27, integration of t is equal to minus pi by 2 to t is equal to pi by 2 1 dt. So 27 t minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, pi by 2 plus pi by 2 pi, so 27 pi. Okay, if this function, the given function is, if it is given as mass density function, then what we have calculated here?
The mass.
If not, if this is just a function above the curve, then we have calculated the
area.
Yeah, area of the
area.
What did I call that?
Curtain.
Right. You understood the concept. Fine. Except maybe how I have represented the derivative function, and I explain you now how to represent any curve in terms of parameter. So that's fair explanation from my point of view. Like if you go back to study about the parameter equation, you can get the idea about it, more idea about. The only thing which I left here that I'm not discussed much is how would I apply the derivative of the curve, and I have written the component of the vector, x and y component of the vector, as the derivative of x of t and y of t. That's it. And that will be discussed some other day. Don't worry. Fine?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm putting up next question here. Xy ds c, where c the segment minus 2 comma minus 1 to 1 comma 3. Okay, see, the c is defined here, that's the segment between minus 2 to minus 1 to 1 comma 3. So here we have to find out the given curve in terms of parameter, in terms of parametric equation. So like in this question, you always make note that these two points are given. Okay, so the t goes from 0 to 1. We'll take this to define parametric equation in the easiest way. Okay, note this. Now see, these the two points are given, okay, and if I want to find out the parametric equation of this curve from minus 2 comma minus 1 to 1 comma 3, okay, so this is the x and y coordinates, right? X and y coordinates are given of those two points. Fine. So the general parametric equation is basically x is equal to c1 plus k1t and y is equal to c2 plus k2t, right? This is the general parametric equation in general, right? Now we have to find out the constants. So like to make this working easy, we have to take the t goes from 0 to 1. So the first value of t is 0. Like this is the first value, t is equal to 0 and t is equal to 1 for this. Okay. So like if you put t is equal to 0, like for t is equal to 0, what is x and y coordinates? What is x coordinate for t is equal to 0?
Minus 2.
Yeah, so we'll use this equation. Minus 2 is equal to c1 plus k1 0. It will directly give you the value of c1. What is the value of c1 here?
Minus 2.
Okay. Now, this minus 2 should be plugged back to the equation. So, x is equal to minus 2 plus
k1t.
Now, I'll use the another value, like another point on this curve. That is 1,3, right? And that happens at t is equal to 1. Okay. So, at t is equal to 1, what is x coordinate?
At t is equal to x coordinate is 1.
1. So, if I plug this value here, it will give us the value of k1. So, 1 is equal to minus 2 plus k1, t is equal to 1. So, 2 plus 1, 3. So, k1 is equal to 3. So, what would be our parameter equation now? So, x is equal to minus 2
plus
3t. So, for our convenience, I have taken the value of t that goes from 0 to 1. Got the idea here? To find out the parameter equation of the given line segment.
Yeah, so that is an arbitrary thing, right?
Yeah. That's the arbitrary thing we have to consider here.
So, if it was any two set of points, that the set of points are given, right? Because the segment.
Yeah, the set of points will be given. Yes.
So, there could be any points.
Any points.
They can be these two, any points. And we can take them as t1, t2, right?
Yeah.
K1, k. Yeah.
T is equal to 0 to t 2 is equal
0
to 1.
T2, 1.
That's to simplify the calculation. You can take any value that will give you the same equation here, same parameter equation. You got the idea here?
Yeah.
Okay. So at t is equal to 0, like for y is equal to, what is y coordinate at t is equal to 0?
Minus 1.
So minus 1 is equal to C2 plus K2 0. So this will directly give you the value of C2, which is minus 1. Now we'll put this C2 back to the equation. So that will give you Y is equal to minus 1 plus K2 T. Now we'll use the another point, which is at t is equal to 1. So for t is equal to 1, y is equal to 3, right? So 3 is equal to minus 1 plus k2 1. So this implies 3 plus 1, 4. So k2 is equal to 4. And the parameter equation is y is equal to minus 1 plus 4t. Okay. See, do you remember the vector from IB where we worked on it, like to find out the parameter equation when two points are given of the line segment, equation of the line in terms of parameter? Do you remember that stuff?
Yeah.
The initial r is equal to a plus lambda b, Manav. R is equal to a plus lambda b.
Yeah.
So the same stuff is going on, but in different way. Okay. The only thing is I need the parameter equation. Whatever means you do, whatever you concept you apply for the given two points, I need the parameter equation. Okay. So x is equal to minus 2 plus 3t. Y is equal to minus 1 plus 4t. Now we got the parameter equation here. Now, what is our job? What they have given this to simplify this integral, right?
Yeah.
So we have to define everything in terms of parameter, right? We have to define the function as well as ds in terms of parameter. So what is ds? What we find out, like what is r bar T here.
It's
root
r by t is x I cap
3 t I plus cap.
Y j cap, right?
Yeah.
What is x?
Yeah. Minus 2 plus 3 t.
Yes, minus 2 plus 3 t I cap plus minus 1 plus 4 t
bracket
j cap
plus t j cap.
Yeah. How would I find the derivative of this?
So it's 3 I cap plus
3 I cap plus
j cap.
4 j cap. Fine. Yeah. Now what is our next job?
The mod, which is 5.
Magnitude of this. Very good. So that's 5. Okay. The mod is root 3 square plus 4 square, which is nothing but 5. Now we have to set up the integral again. The integral given was 2xy ds. How would I set up this? 2, what is x? Perfect. We substitute x and y. Wherever we find x and y, we substitute in terms of parameter. So x is equal to minus 2 plus 3t, y is equal to minus 1 plus 4t, and ds is equal to mod of r dash t dt. So that is 5 dt, right?
Yeah.
But what is the limit? What is the limit of this integral? T goes
zero
from
to
0 to 1. Perfect. Okay. Solve this. The answer will come out as 5. You just have a setup and let's try the next question. You can solve this integral at home. This is just a single integration that we use to solve, right? We'll multiply, we get the some quadratic function maybe, and then we'll simply apply the basic integration rule. Okay, let's try the next question. How to set up the line integral for the next one? I want you to set up this now. See the segment.
I got 5.
You got 5. Awesome. See the segment 1, 1, 0, 2, 3, 1. Okay. Please show your answer on the screen. Let me take the picture of that. Dev. For the record. Your net, just hold on. Maybe it will give us the clear picture. It's not giving us. Okay, fine, no problem. Solve the next one. Your camera is weak, maybe, or my network may be weak. So this is the line integral over the curve C under the function xyz square ds. So what should be our first job here? To find the given curve in terms of parametric equation. Right, for our convenience.
Oh, I have a question.
Yeah.
What is this segment like, the region, what is it like? I
see the like segment may be anything
on a graph.
See, anything on xyz plane with that connecting these two points 1, 1, 0, 2, 3, 1. Okay. Anything that connects these two points, that's the curve, the given curve. So we are finding out that in terms of parameter. okay, the line segment in terms of parameter. Okay. So what is the equation? Say x, y, and z, that will directly become, you know, there that can be written as 1 1 0, that's the initial point, plus kt plus kt plus kt. See, for t is equal to 0, it will directly give you this equation, right? Now to find out k, we have to plug t the x, y, z for t is equal to 1, right? This is our parametric equation that we learned in IB, right? Isn't it, Mano? X is equal to the initial points, 1 plus kt lambda t. Here the only thing I have replaced lambda by k. Okay.
Yeah.
So if I plug t is equal to 1, t is equal to 1, t is equal to 1 here. So 2 is equal to 1 plus k, and k is 1. 3 is equal to 1 plus k, and k is equal to 2. 1 is equal to 0 plus k, and k is equal to 1. Okay. So what is my parametric equation? What will be my parametric equation here? X is equal to?
X is equal to 1 plus
1
t.
Plus t.
Yeah. 1 plus t.
Y is equal to?
Y is equal to 1 plus?
Y
take the corresponding k value, no?
1 plus 2.
Perfect. And z is equal to? Just t.
1 plus?
Just t. 1 t.
Zero. Right. So once we find the given line segment in terms of parameter, okay, that's the curve connecting these two points. Okay, so we have to find out the its vector form of this, right? So vector form, the position vector is r bar t, and that is like their x components are given, 1 plus t I cap. Y component is 1 plus 2t j cap, and z component is just t k cap. Got the idea here? See, the line is also represented in terms of parameter. Okay, this is the parameter equation of the line. This is not new, dude. This is not new. We already studied these things before, right?
Yeah.
Now we find out the derivative of this, that's the tangent. So tangent of this curve, so we can find out by finding out the derivative of the given x, y, z components. So that's I cap plus 2 j cap plus what, k cap
plus k cap.
Yeah, so mod of this is 1 plus 4 plus 1,
root 6.
Now we set up the integral here. Now we'll set up the integral. The integral is x, y, z square ds. Okay, so we replace x by 1 plus t, y by 1 plus 2t, and z by t square. Yeah, t square, z square become t square. And like Jacobian, we studied, we never forget this root 6 also. That is the mod of r dash t. So, and dt. And where t goes from?
0 to 1.
0 to 1. Okay. Find out the value to this integral, that should come out as 89 root 6 upon 60. You can do that later. This is simple one variable integration. Okay.
Yeah.
Now, suppose the curve which is given is not smooth. See, only condition is whatever we have, like curve and the function, that has to be differentiable, isn't it? If that is not smooth, are you getting that? See, my if my curve has sharp edge, or that it's not smooth, there is a break or there is a cusp. Okay, so in that case we need more than one line integral, right? Are you getting that? So in that, because whatever, see, we are differentiating it. Okay, we are differentiating this function is also converted into in terms of parameter. So if my curve is not differentiable at certain point between the given points, okay, so that has to be broken into two different segments, and we need more than one line integral to find out the mass of that wire. Got the idea here?
Yeah.
So please note that C must be smooth, and if there is a break or cusp or sharp change, then the mass idea will be derived in more than one line integral. Okay, we have to break the given curve into two segments, C1, C2, and we apply the same concept to figure out the line integral. The only obstacle here is, if curve is not smooth, how would we find the derivative for the this type of surface, for this type of curve? You got the idea here? This function is not differentiable.
So you will make two functions, right? One of that and one of that.
Yeah, we need two curves. So that I have mentioned here, no? C1, C2. So this is C1, this is C2, and we need more than one line integral, right? If there is more than one break, or there is more than one cusp. You got the whole idea here. Please give me the honest feedback on this.
Yeah.
I found it very interesting. Yeah.
Cool. Okay, so have you completed this integration? The last what I put here was value 89 by 60.
Yeah,
you got that, Mana?
Show that
on the screen. Okay, I'm not able to zoom it because my mouse is not working now. Okay, no problem. Okay, so we stop here. That's simple integration. You can always do that. Okay, my mouse is not working. Okay, so we stop class today. We'll meet tomorrow. What time?
So to be honest, I prefer like the afternoon timings are nice.
Nice. Okay. So we'll keep 4 o'clock only.
Yeah. No problem. Let's keep it 4 only.
Okay. So this whole week we'll keep class at 4. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Bye bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, sir. Bye.